Breaking, FBI makes powerful new announcement, Libs hate it. According to the Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI, more Americans are embracing their Second Amendment rights. On Saturday, the FBI announced that it received over 200,000 requests for background checks for firearms purchases on Black Friday. This number sets a new record for background checks in one day. This number, which was reported by the FBI's National Instant Criminal Background Check System, represents a significant increase in the number of gun owners. The previous record for background checks on a single day was 185,713 in 2016. On Saturday, the total number was 203,086. Both records were set on Black Friday. While the number of background checks has clearly risen, it's unclear how many guns were purchased on Saturday. However, it is likely that the number of weapons sold was higher than the number of background checks, because consumers sometimes purchase more than one gun in a single transaction. On Wednesday, Attorney General Jeff Sessions ordered a review of the NICS, which is a government database that federally licensed gun sellers use for background checks. This was in response to the Sutherland Springs church shooting that left 26 people dead. The shooter who carried out the attack was not included in the system, despite having a criminal record in the military for domestic violence. This enabled him to legally purchase the weapons he used in the attack. According to Sessions, the fact that the Sutherland Springs gunman was able to obtain weapons was an indicator that all necessary information is not being included in the NICS. This could mean that others could be obtaining weapons, even though they have criminal convictions. The Attorney General ordered the FBI and the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms and Explosives to conduct a comprehensive review of the NICS and report back to me the steps we can take to ensure that those who are prohibited from purchasing firearms are prevented from doing so. The debate over gun control has grown more intense over the course of 2017. Whenever a mass shooting occurs, the left inevitably uses the tragedy to promote their anti-Second Amendment agenda. They somehow believe that making it more difficult for law-abiding citizens to obtain the means to defend themselves will decrease mass shootings. The reality is that the cities with the strictest gun control laws have the most gun deaths. Chicago is a prime example of a city whose government places harsh restrictions on gun ownership, but has one of the highest murder rates in the world. The Sutherland Springs church shooting is an example of why good citizens should be allowed to have firearms. The shooter could have killed far more victims if an armed citizen didn't stop him. It is imperative that Americans prevent the left from passing more laws that restrict their right to gun ownership. While the left claims that they do not wish to seize people's weapons, it is clear that this is their main objective. Americans must continue to make sure that the government is not empowered to violate Americans' Second Amendment rights. Otherwise, it will become easier for them to violate other rights.